The SAP Community Groups are the best place to connect and engage with our 165,000 community members to get answers, discuss best practices, and continually learn about SAP solutions. Today, I want to bring to your attention the SAP Builders Group, where you can engage with community of peers to unleash innovation by building apps, process automations, and science without writing code. Check out the discussions, blog posts, and feature topics such as how-to, links to videos, and release updates. The link is below where you can join the group and subscribe to announcements. I hope to see you there.
Did you know that while opening an ABAP development object in ADT, you can make use of Content Assist? You can narrow down your search using object type group, owner name, etc. In this particular example, I'm trying to search for a CDS view with S flight in its name.
Hey there, Paul Pinard wrote a new blog post, AI Foundation, SAP's all-in-one AI toolkit for developers. And it is a must-read for every developer. If you have wondered until now how you can leverage AI, or even if you should use AI in your applications, I am sure you will discover many areas where AI Foundation on SAP BTP can help your use case. In this blog post, Paul gives a summary of all the AI tools SAP has to offer within the AI Foundation, starting with the ready-to-use AI services for document processing, recommendations, and translation. This month, we will also launch the Document Information Extraction Premium Edition, which supports over 40 languages and uses generative AI to perform even better. So if that sounds interesting, make sure to check out the ticket session that's linked in the comments. He also describes how you can use SAP AI Core and SAP AI Launchbit for all your custom AI development, and he introduces the Generative AI Hub, which is available early next year. You can manage all the functionalities of the Generative AI Hub also in SAP AI Launchpad, of course, and also do tasks such as model grounding with your own data. And not to forget all the HANA machine learning functionalities, ranging from HANA Predictive Analysis Library to the new HANA Vector Store. With HANA Vector Store, you can also implement retrieval augmented generation use cases like we showed in the developer keynote during Ticket. The link is also in the comments. And for all the other data management, SAP offers SAP Data Sphere. Paul also gives a sneak peek into what SAP is doing with large language models and structured data. So that's really interesting. Make sure to check out the blog post and you will learn a lot about our AI portfolio.
The new version of SAP HANA Database Explorer extension for the Visual Studio Code was recently released, and it came with a solid number of great new features, like local database connections to HDI containers, or improved database objects dependency viewer. Jonathan Bregler wrote a blog post to present some of them in detail. Please read his 2023 recap and leave your comment about what new features you would like to see improving your experience building intelligent data applications with SAP HANA. Talking about intelligent data apps, the recording of this week's webinar, Leverage the Latest Innovative Capabilities of SAP HANA Cloud, is available. Our colleagues from the COE presented use cases leveraging multimodal capabilities of SAP HANA Cloud, along with the solution architecture diagrams and code repositories. Find the link to the recording in the description. And if you are looking for introductory hands-on experience with SAP HANA Cloud tools building intelligent data apps, then please check out our SAP CodeGen community events program. We just had a successful event on getting started with machine learning this week in Düsseldorf, and I'm looking forward to 2024. Where in the world would you like to host the next SAP CodeGen on this topic?
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. If you are a JavaScript developer, consider taking part in the annual State of JS survey. The survey's goal is to measure the awareness and popularity of JavaScript features, libraries, and frameworks. OpenUI5, for example, which turns 10 years old this month, by the way, can be selected in the survey too. The survey runs until December 12th, so check it out and see you soon. Bye.